People with blood disorders like hemophilia look at the world a little bit differently. A simple bump, bruise, or a cut can be life-threatening.
The disease is managed with injections and infusions, and that is especially tough on children. But as KXAN's Amanda Brandeis explains, researchers at UT Austin are transforming treatment, making it cheaper and less painful.
This is kind of the longest part. The sanding.
As she slowly transforms a piece of plywood into Christmas decor, Shelley Clausen can't help but count her blessings.
Just his zest for life and his smile is just, he always has a smile.
She's talking about her son, Jace. 7 days after he was born, their entire world changed overnight.
It was scary, and we rushed him to Dell Children's where they were able to stop the bleeding.
Jace was diagnosed with hemophilia, which means a slight injury could turn into a serious bleed.
We usually treat it using an IV medication. So that means a tiny little one-year-old, two-year-old has to get poked in the hands or in the arms multiple times per week.
As he got older, obviously crawling around, pulling up, things like that, that was a scary time for me.
Because sometimes the bleed is hidden and can happen in the joints, muscle, or head.
UT researchers are giving new hope to these families, envisioning a future without needles. They've developed a capsule that does the same thing.
To take a pill and know that you can be treated the same way would be a miracle.
While it could be a few years before the drug is available, the breakthrough gives them hope for a better future. Amanda Brandeis, KXAN News.
UT researchers say the new treatment could help all hemophilia B patients, but those in developing countries will benefit the most. Current needle-based treatment can have complications, and it is more expensive.
Hemophilia is a genetic disorder. About one in every 5,000 children has it, and most of the time it's boys who get it. And this chart helps us understand the risk. Girls only get it if they get the gene from both their mother and father. Boys are more at risk because they get it with just one gene from their mother. And women can carry this gene without having it. So women with a family history of hemophilia are usually tested to see if they are a carrier.